Demographers have a pretty good handle on the big picture trends that shape world population growth over the next 80 years. Fertility rates are fairly straightforward to model because they move in very similar patterns across countries. As countries get richer, women get more educated, access to contraception goes up, and fertility rates fall. This is happening much more quickly now than it did in the past. It took the United States 80 years to go from 6 births per woman to 3 births per woman. Countries are completing that transition now in only 10 to 20 years. So what demographers can do is they can take existing forecasts of long-run economic growth, rising access to women's education and contraception, and have a pretty good handle on what will happen to population growth over the next 100 years. A study was just published in The Lancet with revised estimates for population growth using a plausibly better methodology than the existing mainline UN estimates. And what it finds is that population growth may actually be slower than what was previously forecast. According to the new study, world population is going to peak in 2064 and then fall to about 8.8 billion by the year 2100. This is about 2 billion less than what previous studies had predicted. But it's quite a different world than our world today. The study predicted that China and Japan would have about half the population that they have today, and that the population of sub-Saharan Africa would be up to about 3 billion, 3 times higher than it is today. The biggest difference between the new model and the prior models is how it forecasts fertility change in countries that have already fallen below replacement rate, like Europe and South Korea. The old models predicted that fertility rates would start rising again in places where they've fallen to 1 or 1.5 births per woman. But actually, in most countries, that hasn't happened. When fertility rates fall, they tend to stay low. This makes a big difference in long-run estimates of population change, but it's really highly uncertain. Many countries have policies in place which haven't worked so far to try to raise fertility rates, but we don't know what is going to happen. So all of these forecasts should be taken with a large dose of salt. Less population growth means less pressure on the planet's finite resources. That's a very good thing. Most of the population growth in the next 80 years is going to come from sub-Saharan Africa. The world will be in much better shape if the next 2 billion Africans grow up with high economic opportunity and high education levels. Making that happen is a responsibility for the whole world. The new study predicts that there will be about 350 million Americans in 2100. That's about the same number as there are today. The United States has done a good job of balancing low fertility rates with moderate immigration. This approach has helped us maintain a high working age population to support the growing number of elderly people. An added side benefit is the United States has been very successful at attracting the best and brightest scientists and researchers who have been the driver of economic growth for many decades. There's something of a backlash against immigration right now, but the benefits to the United States of immigration are huge. If we close those doors, the United States will be facing both a demographic and a scientific decline.